Luke. Blue, please travel across the galaxy to the mighty BlizzCon. And you know what we got?
No, Father. What did you get?
This lousy t-shirt.
Ladies and gentlemen, do not be alarmed. A cynical Brit has been allowed on the air with a microphone. You will listen, or the kitten we have hostage will be forced to fight a giant badger. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a Blue Please. Enjoy. Wow.
Radio.
Yes, indeed, folks. This is another edition of Blue Please with myself, Total Biscuit, right here on WoW Radio on your Sunday evening, or your Sunday afternoon, or whatever time you happen to be listening to this archive. It's a crazy moon time kind of conspiracy, and we don't like it. Anyway, that's enough bollocks to start with, so what's coming up in the rest of the show? Right, advance apology. Now, before my show, at least until about 20 minutes before the pre-show, my mic wasn't working. And half my features are pre-recorded. So as you can imagine, attempting to get that many features done in 20 minutes proved to be a little bit tricky. So I managed to get wrapping the forums done, and I am going to play some archive footage for the rest and hope that you don't notice. Yeah, you'll never notice. I'll fool you all. Or maybe not. Anyway, so this show... I've been to BlizzCon, we buffered, and I will be talking a lot about that, let me put it that way. That's going to be the entire focus of this show. BlizzCon, expansion, BlizzCon. Seems logical to me. If you have any complaints, well, go and die somewhere. So, what am I going to talk about first? It's really quite simple. The first thing I'm going to talk about is something that I usually do not even go anywhere near. That is Blizzard themselves. Now, let me tell you the story of BlizzCon this year and WoW Radio's coverage of it. I landed in Santa Ana, also known as John Wayne Airport, on the Tuesday at around 7 o'clock local time, having spent 12 hours on a plane, having, in fact, ingested what was claimed to be chicken, but quite frankly was not, and having sat through the terrible in-flight movie, which was Bewitched, which I might add is totally rubbish. Now, what's your point, you may ask? Well, the point is simple. I travelled 5,500 miles to come and broadcast this event, along with the rest of our team. Three guys from the UK came. Slanik doesn't really count. Slanik came from Ireland, and he's sort of some kind of illegal alien, but myself, Kiki, Jiki and Slanik flew over from the UK to America to broadcast this event. Now, we paid this out of our own pocket. Now, Blizzard provided us with hotel rooms and press passes. Much appreciated. Having said that, I did pay for the plane ticket, and it was substantially more than the hotel room, let me tell you that. Anyway, back to the story. So I land over there. It's all good. Everything's fine. We meet the WoW Radio crew. We are greeted with a large jug of Kool-Aid, which was apparently made in the sink. Why you people can drink this, I really don't know. It's simply colouring and what appears to be some kind of sherbety substance in liquid. Why? Anyway, so we arrive at the hotel. Everything's good. Everything's fine. We do our video test and we start to prep. Now, I'm told by Athelas, our station manager, or station controller, whatever you would like to call him, that we will be getting a walkthrough of the convention centre on the Tuesday. Now, that will allow us to get an internet connection set up. That will allow us to check the place out, see where we need to go, get hold of, hopefully, the schedule of events so that we can plan our filming and coverage accordingly, and get our equipment set down, set up, and hopefully working. This didn't happen. Now, I'm not going to mention any names whatsoever on Blizzard's side, because, quite frankly, it would be unfair to tar all of Blizzard with the same brush. However, in this respect, there was a failing. Okay, I thought. Right. Well, they're obviously getting ready. It's okay. They'll do it later. Yeah. So they say, okay, 7 o'clock. Actually, they said 5. 5 o'clock on the Thursday. You can come and do a walkthrough. Okay, I said. That's all good. So we went back to our hotel room. We went to, I believe, an Outback restaurant. We went to the IHOP. That was funny. Pancakes for breakfast. Unacceptable. So we come back. And we're told, no, you can't have a walkthrough. Come back at 7. Okay, we'll come back at 7. We come back at 7. Sorry, we're not doing walkthroughs. What? Now, we're a little bit bemused at this point because we've sort of worked our schedule around this, and obviously we need to set up. This is something we've never tried before, and we need time to prepare to make sure that we get a good broadcast out there. Added to this, we are actually told that we are not going to be given a table. My reaction to that was stark despair and amazement. How do you expect a radio broadcasting organization to do broadcasts live, including commentary, without a table to set up our equipment on? Bearing in mind we had 2 to 3 laptops, a large video encoding machine, 3 microphones, and 3 video cameras, as well as all the cables and standard equipment you would need for such an operation. Sorry, but we weren't going to dump all of that on the floor. So, Mickey C, one of our staff members, goes home to get a table, and we basically hope that they will allow us in with it. Now, the day of the convention comes, and we are told that we can go in early. 7 o'clock early, in fact. This didn't happen. We're then told 8. This didn't happen. 9? No, this didn't happen either. When did we get in? 9:40. That's 20 minutes before the general public were allowed in. Added to which, they said specifically that no press would be allowed in. However, they did let some press in, including a certain Tristan Pope in his silly Murloc outfit. Now, apparently Tristan Pope and his silly Murloc outfit and the other press that were allowed in had priority over us. Interesting. Now, at this point, I sort of was losing faith in this company. Now, surely this is a company that wants to support its fan endeavours. Now, surely they also want to support the fact that we have flown over there on our own money, on our own time. We have bought our own equipment, brought it along, and said, we're going to broadcast your event to thousands for free. We ask nothing more than being able to get in there and do our job. Should be fine. Apparently not. Dismay was my reaction. And then, quite frankly, a little bit of anger. What right do people have to treat us like this? We're a fan site. Is this how certain people at Blizzard treat the fan sites? Is this the way you treat your loyal customers? People who have gone above and beyond the call of duty, as it were, have put out some serious time and dedication in order to be the best fan site they could possibly be. Effectively, psych people up for your product for and require absolutely nothing in return other than the occasional thank you and a little bit of cooperation where required. Dismay. So, we get in there. Finally, with our equipment. We have a table! Brilliant! It's a strange-looking round table. Preferred a rectangular-shaped table, but never mind. Never mind. It'll do. So we get in there. I say, oh, you're around there. Okay, we're behind a large, giant projector screen. The projector screen being where the commentary and the StarCraft and Warcraft 3 tournaments would be projected. What's the problem? It's pitch black. Those of you who watched the coverage on the first day will notice that our coverage was quite dark. That is the reason. It does seem a little bit odd to me that since Blizzard were well aware that we were going to do video broadcasting, why exactly would they put us in an area which is almost pitch black? Confusing. But never mind. So we get set up. The internet connection isn't ready. Now, this is fine. They were in a rush. And quite frankly, I would like to praise the Blizzard and Vivendi technical staff who were incredibly helpful. Incredibly helpful at the event. And after a few technical hiccups, everything was working as intended. So we get on with our coverage. We do our opening show while the camera crew goes over to video the big announcement, which turned out to be the expansion pack and playable Zerg in StarCraft Ghost. Now, we get back and we continue. Now, we're speaking on air as we usually do, in a candid and honest fashion, and we get word that apparently some Blizzard staff are unhappy with what we've been saying. Apparently, we have been bad-mouthing their staff. Now, that really did alarm me. It made me think, one, who is telling people things, and two, we didn't badmouth their staff at all. What we did was express perfectly valid concerns to the state of the event and the organization and the cooperation which was being put in our direction. Again, the technical staff did a stand-up job. It's unfortunate that certain other staff were not capable of doing that. Now, during the event, we were promised various things, which we did not receive, I might add. We didn't. We received none of it. And, quite frankly, I left that event thinking, we've done a lot of work for a company which doesn't seem to appreciate it. It's hard not to feel a little bit disheartened when the company you have set up a large fan site for, broadcasted, spent hours and hours and hours and hours, days of your life, attempting to do all of this kind of stuff, and what happens? Now, this wasn't all that happened. Because the day before the convention, we saw an announcement go up on BlizzCon.com. What was that announcement? Other stations will be broadcasting the event live. What? We thought we had no idea of this. Some of you may or may not be aware that we got an announcement about a month ago before BlizzCon as to our involvement. That's cool. We thought, yeah, good idea. We got a listenership spike then. We got lots more people in. We got people listening to the archives and people generally seeing interest in the station. As usual, that died off. Now, 2 days, and I would call this prime time before the event, two other stations, one video and one radio, were put on the front page and said, these guys are going to be broadcasting the event live. We thought, this has got to be a mistake, a miscommunication. So we contacted Blizzard, and there was no mistake. This was planned. It's hard not to feel a little bit betrayed in that situation. And you know what was worse? Blizzard have made themselves look a little bit foolish. What they said on the front page, these organizations will be broadcasting the event live. And what happened? No, they didn't. In fact, what they were doing was what they always intended to do, that was to broadcast the tournament. Because, in reality, these stations are tournament broadcasters. That's what they're good at, and that's what they did. In an exceptional manner. Praise be to them. I listened to the commentary, I watched the tournament, I was damn impressed. And it's great to see people getting off their asses and doing that. It does make me wonder if they suffered the same kind of treatment. Now, what am I going to conclude from this? Let me put it this way. It crossed my mind to stop doing this show. It seemed to me, why should I bother doing this show and effectively bigging up a company that doesn't really deserve it? A company that's treated us in a subpar and quite frankly upsetting manner. And I thought, no, I'm not going to do that because that would be giving up. What I am going to do, however, is stop giving Blizzard the benefit of the doubt. You may be aware that this show has been known for bigging up Blizzard, bigging up the game, and I enjoy the game. It's a great game. However, in this case, I'm not happy with the way we were treated. And I don't see why I should continue to give a company that treated us in such a manner the benefit of the doubt when it's blindingly obvious that I've seen the evidence firsthand that apparently some of this benefit of the doubt they did not deserve. Now, they are a company. That's fine. I understand that. They're out to make money. That's cool. That's the way it should be. However, when it comes to public relations, the words "not impressed" sprang to mind. You listen to Blue Please here on WoW Radio. The rest of the show is going to be covering Expansion and BlizzCon, so stay tuned for that. Here's a little bit of Camelot. This is the March of Mephisto. Enjoy.